Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Filip Testimontowski, and I'm a caster, an expert, and a host of esport tournaments. 6 years in the industry. In 2019, I hosted about 20 events, including Intel Extreme Masters. Today, I'm here for you. Welcome everyone on GovTech Festival and Game Jam, which takes place through the partnership of Industry Development Agency and GovTech Poland. Thank you to our partners, GovTech Poland, Cancellary of the Prime Minister, Industry Development Agency, Polish Investment and Trade Agency, IGF, and HackYeah. Among today's guests, we will see United Nations representative Mr. Yu Wangzhou, who is current director of the Department of Public Institutions and Digital Government, DESA. In this position, he leads a team dedicated to normative, analytical, and capacity-building work to promote inclusive, effective, and responsible institutions that are well-prepared to achieve the goals of the digital economy. Our second guest is Justyna Arłowska, Polish Prime Minister's High Representative for Government Technology. Leading expert in corporate finance and fund management, having previously worked in consulting, in 2016 she became an advisor to the Minister of Economic Development. Responsible for management of the state's Innovate Projects portfolio, she spearheaded the MinFinTech program as well as the creation of the lektury.gov.pl portal. In 2017, appointed an advisor to the Prime Minister on Innovation Policy and Finance. Since the programs established in April 2018, serving as head of the GovTech Poland program, Poland's largest initiative aimed at bringing and implementing the innovation and digital revolution to the public sector. Appointed to Prime Minister's High Representative for Government Technology in March 2020. Another guest is Krzysztof Schubert, Republic of Poland Plenipotentiary for UN-IGF 2021, President of the Management Board NCBR Investment Fund. Former Secretary of State and Government Plenipotentiary for DSM. Senior-level executive with 25-year track record of strategic leadership within ICT industry. Let me introduce our next expert, Jakub Marszałkowski, co-founder and board member of the Indie Games Poland industry organization. Kuba works at the Faculty of Information Technology and Telecommunications at the Poznan University of Technology. And he's also developing his career as the head of the Games Industry Conference, an important European event. Our guests will present us the current situation in the gaming industry, hackathon and the whole specificity of the GovTech Festival, as well as the potential of the game and technology industry market. Okay, so now, let's go to Game Jam. Game Jam Hackathon is aimed at game dev industry, where teams compete against each other. Each team creates one game within 40 hours to compete for one of the attractive prizes. To start with, I would like to know how GovTech sees Game Jam. Is this just one event?
Speaking of games, we wanted to take this year's Game Jam to a whole new level. Last year, hundreds of developers, graphic designers, and other creators gathered in Warsaw for the continent's largest gaming hackathon. They showed the world how to bring the event's keyword responsibility to life using keyboards, pads, and joysticks. It was a time of many emotions, many plot twists, but above all, many games which showed us all that they let us combine technological mastery and entertainment. But for us in Poland, games aren't about computer code, but the values they convey. Polish school children learn from them about compassion, solidarity, and empathy, and bring those values into adult lives. Supporting both them and the game creators is a part of our mission as GovTech Polska. This is why this year our Game Jam is a part of a wider initiative aimed at promoting exactly these values, the GovTech Festival. we see that during the global pandemic, people are more and more inclined to support others in this time of need. The festival aims to honor those who help bring others into the digital world and teach them how to move around it in a safe and responsible way. During the festival, we want to show that new technologies can help us all become better, more compassionate global citizens. We believe that nothing will achieve this goal better than a gaming marathon, and this is why we couldn't imagine a better way to kick off the festival.
The first guest will be Jakub Marszałkowski, who conducted the survey, The Game Industry of Poland 2020. And he has a great idea how the game market looks like at the moment and what its future potential is. So let's listen to some interesting facts.
Hello, I'm Jakub Marszałkowski and I do my best to work for the Polish game industry. I'm part of the Indie Games Poland, which is a developer organization here helping developers, helping producers. I also do organize game industry conference, maybe the biggest event around. And I'm teaching at Poznań Technical University, teaching game design, obviously. I wanted to tell you a few important things about Polish game industry. It grew big. It's over 440 studios right now developing games here. You probably know the high-end part of this scale, like CD Projekt Red, Witcher, Cyberpunk, obviously that are the biggest brands we have, and the most famous, the Mimic one, actually. But there is obviously Techland with Dying Light series. There is 11 bits with their awarded titles like This War of Mine, like Frostpunk. On mobile part, there is Huge Games and 10 Square Games producing big and successful mobile titles. And there is much more. What's maybe more interesting for you as possible participants of the Game Jam, and also what is less displayed part of this industry, is the other end. I would say we have like at least half a dozen of tiny studios, one person studio, single indie developer doing nearly everything at their game, doing programming, doing design, doing graphics, sometimes outsourcing some parts of it, but still being a very independent solo developer. And we have at least six of those that we could point that managed to produce games that sold worldwide in some hundreds of thousand copies, some of them even over 500,000 copies of single game sold. Obviously, those are smaller games, sometimes mobile, sometimes PC. They are lower priced. It will be sometimes $2 games. But, well, 500,000 copies of a game, that's a huge thing. That's lots of players all around the world playing your game. And I think that's also very important that this thing is happening. This brings us to another interesting topic. Game production, game sales, game market are quite different from other industries that might be around for a bit longer. If someone is producing food, clothing, probably even movies, it's usually being done mostly for the domestic market. With games, it's completely opposite. The 440 Polish companies are producing games mostly for export. I would say like nearly every game is exported. It would be difficult to find a game produced strictly for Polish market. And also over 96% of incomes for those companies comes from export of games. Obviously, we have big market for gaming in Poland, especially PC gaming here is really strong. We are one of the top markets for PC gaming. But Polish gamers, like most of the Western gamers, are mostly playing global titles. All the big global titles that are popular everywhere are popular here as well. And the domestic production of games is only smaller part of what Polish gamers are gaming. Obviously, they do like Polish games, they do play them, but the big global titles are awesome and everyone wants to play them. I would imagine that there are countries where this share of local games in the local market would be even smaller if the production is not that big. This gets completely different on Asian markets. On Asian markets, gamers tend to play local games, games that are closer to the their culture, what the two things they like that are more localized and stuff like this. So with 96% of Polish games exported, where do they reach? The main market for Polish games is United States, but if we consider European Union as whole, it would be similar. It only few percents smaller than the reach we have in United States. In European Union, obviously the most important markets would be United Kingdom, not wrong there in European Union, but okay, let's focus on the past numbers. So United Kingdom, France and Germany, with the rest forming also a formidable part. We are not exporting that many games for Asia. They are not always suitable, they are not always fitting culture, but we have some big and popular exports. For example, Polish horror games, we do produce quite many horror games, are quite popular in Japan, for example. So there are some exemptions from that. We have a reasonable share of sales in Southern America, in Australia. I would say that would be around what those markets are part of the global game market. So Polish games are reaching in different ways nearly everywhere. Actually, Polish games might be the biggest Polish cultural export, like more people abroad know Polish games that knows of Polish movies, music and books. This is the way Polish culture can reach the world. But let's back for a moment to how big Polish game industry actually is. The thing that surprises us most at our recent research was that it counts almost 10,000 people producing in some ways games in Poland. We already knew for some time that our previous estimate, which was 6,000, is not longer valid. It's definitely more, but actual count of 9,710 people surprised even us. It's huge growth. The number of studios is not growing that fast. We had 400, now we have 440, so it's like 10%, only 40 studios more over some 3 years. There is some change in the number of studios. Some smaller did not manage to survive. Some new were created in their place, and it's a normal process everywhere. Not every game produced case can succeed. That's completely normal. But the growth on the number of employees, on the number of people producing game, that's not slowing down. It's nearly 25% every year, and if it continues like that, it would be totally crazy, because in few years you would reach 20,000 or something like this. So maybe this will slow down a little bit as well, but there is change happening. So if there are not that many new studios and the number of people is growing still, it means the studios are getting bigger. Obviously, again, the biggest example of that would be CD Projekt SA, or if with all the subsidiaries reaching over 1,100 people, it's huge. But we also see that yesterday's 20 people studios now are 40 or 50. Studios that were 40 some 2 years ago now are 80 or 90. Everyone that achieved some degree of success is growing. Do we achieve success? Yes, I think we are. The income of the industry, the revenue on selling games and services, reached almost $500 million recently, which is really nice. It's maybe not as successful as some bigger industries. We have to catch up here a little, but we are doing that. If you were watching some recent releases of hardware, conferences like Xbox, like Nvidia, like AMD, every one of those presenting games had a little, at least one Polish game. So if there is always at least one Polish game in five, in a dozen, it means we can provide quality. We're producing top chart games. We are up to the state of the art. We do really deliver. The games produced in Poland sum up to some 480 releases a year. We do count separate platforms as separate releases, so completely original titles would be around half of that. Until recently, most of the titles were hitting PC first. As we do game mostly on PC in Poland, we also produce mostly for PCs in Poland. However, in 2019, the releases for Switch overdid that. We did many ports for Switch of games that were previously released to some other platforms. We did some Switch-dedicated releases. Actually, we do maybe get some specialization in the Switch market. We do also release on other consoles. That would be around 25 releases yearly on both Xbox and PlayStation. And we do produce a lot of mobile games, which are, however, more difficult to track. I don't know a good way to track all the mobile premieres. It's too many of them. Not all of them, those games obviously are super successful. Some of them happen to have some troubles, that's normal way. But you definitely could point some big Polish hits recently and you are expecting new ones. Business-wise, there are also interesting factors to discuss. Over 40 Polish game studios are listed on Warsaw Stock Exchange, the Polish Stock Exchange, and this is one of the biggest numbers in the world. Only Tokyo Stock Exchange has more game companies listed. This is also increasing rapidly. There is a rush of Polish studios to be on Warsaw Stock Exchange as soon as possible. But we should also note that if it's over 40 noted, that this means that there is nearly 400 that are privately owned. The funny thing here is that the Polish game industry is very, very Polish. The owners of the studios are usually Polish. We have no single subsidiary of the biggest giants like Electronic Arts of Ubisoft. They are circling around but never dared to open their studio in Poland. I don't know why. What's also interesting is the spread of the sizes of the studios. Over a dozen of studios is bigger than 100 people. There are some other giants that have several hundred, like some of them mentioned, Techland, Huge Games, Ten Square Games. Those are several hundred people companies. There are several big factories that produce games for others that are also several hundred people strong. But the other end of the spread is also huge. So over 40% of companies are really small, six or less people. Is six people enough to produce successful games? Obviously is. They show it all the time. They have their titles selling all over the world. Obviously this will not be another Cyberpunk, but this can be some awesome indie game pushing boundaries of what we know as a gaming a little bit, and they do that. What also grew very quickly in Poland recently is teaching for the game dev, for the companies. We have the offer of the studies of different types is over 60 right now at over 40 universities all around the country. You can study game programming, game art, game design, music and audio, game studies and a lot of different stuff. Recently, even some management for game industry studies were started. So it's quickly growing with big and interesting offer for young people that would like to do some studies, do some games in future. But if you want to do games in future, if you are wannabe game developer, if you are beginner game developer, I think the most important what you can do is game jamming. I know there is a game jam about to happen. I hope that lots of people watching this, listening to this, will be attending this game jam. Game jam, personally, I'm a huge fan. I did organize over a dozen of them. I did send Polish people to another dozen or something international ones. When I can, I participate, I team with some students or some young developers to do a game on Game Jam. Game Jam is absolutely fantastic thing in at least three factors. There is mobilization, there is trial and error, and there is opportunity to meet new people. Let's start with the mobilization. Game Jam offers some short time scale, and what I always see on Game Jams, people within that short time period are actually achieving more due to extreme mobilization, due to sometimes some sleep deprivation, but they do achieve a lot more than they would do in much longer period normally. The games that are coming out of a game jam are often promising, are testing some interesting ideas, are, well, they have bugs, they are not finished, but that's not the goal of the game jam. The experimentation, yeah, that's the goal of the game jam. Do you know that Superhot, one of the bigger Polish games, originates from a game jam? Yeah, it was an idea that was created on a game jam, that was an idea that was tested on a game jam. Will that be playable? Will that be cool? And then it was developed for some long time, over 2 years after the game jam, a lot of work after the game jam, until it became ready commercial product. But without the initial idea, without the testing on the game jam, can that work? It would not be possible. I do encourage you to experiment on a game jam with new ideas, with maybe new tools and production stack, maybe cooperating with some new people. It's a lot of possibilities that you could learn, experiment and test new stuff on game jam. And yes, the people. Try to avoid sticking on a game jam to people that you know exactly and work with them for some long time. Try to find some other group and see how others work, what ideas they have, what troubles will be meeting your group, what tools will be used there. That's also a huge opportunity that you can have out of game jam. And yes, game companies were looking on whom to employ. They do care for game jams that you manage to produce some game on. That's also interesting experience. Maybe not enough, definitely not a one game jam, but you need to jam to be better game producer, game developer, game programmer, game artist. That's very good training. I hope to see you all on the game jam. Bye.
As you can see, the growth and development of the gaming industry in Poland is huge and leaves a lot of space to explore it and use it to develop the economy. I'm also curious how digitalization affects individual elements in the state and society, and I think that Mr. Krzysztof Schubert could say something more on this subject.
Hello, vibrant internet society. Hello, gamers. I'm so glad that despite the worldwide COVID-19 pandemic, we still have the possibility to meet thanks to the internet. Needless to say, the pandemic shows that the internet plays an important role in our everyday lives and that the importance of information and communication technologies is constantly growing. Internet and internet-based technologies over recent years have given us the possibility to interconnect around the globe. This is unquestionable. Needless to say, COVID-19 has demonstrated its even bigger usefulness. Now, without traveling, we can connect with the other side of the globe to discuss businesses. We can take part in the conference being held thousands of miles away, exchange opinions, broaden horizons, meet new people. Years ago, it was a privilege accorded only to some number of people. Nowadays, anyone with the internet connection can experience it. And it is one of the benefits brought to the public by digitalization. Digitalization is especially important from the government's perspective, where introducing fully operable e-administration is of a key importance. Naturally, here comes the question of interoperability and making many different systems accessible and interoperable despite barriers. This may be challenging, of course.
What is European strategy and development plan for the next months and years?
For the last decade, Polish digital policy has to a great extent been aligned with the European Digital Single Market Strategy. We share the view of the Commission that the digital technologies every day prove their high value for all areas of life. The importance increases in crisis situation where physical mobility is limited. We emphasize the need to launch trusted, secure, and decentralized cloud services within the EU. Therefore, we welcome the concept of the EU federated cloud infrastructure and encourage the European Commission to continue this work quickly. EU solutions in the field of cloud computing should be based on such principles as decentralization of solutions, data sharing, mutual recognition of standards. Those tools will be beneficial not only for business, but will facilitate access to e-government services. The EU needs to consolidate the EU cybersecurity system, which is currently insufficiently effective due to the fragmentation of legislation in which security is regulated. Particular attention should be paid to the development of a common approach based on risk management and the unification of the cyber incidents reporting system. To ensure rapid development of 5G across EU, we underline the need to establish an effective and systematic approach to tackling disinformation regarding electromagnetic fields and 5G networks. We should strive to create solutions based on human-centric artificial intelligence. Human dignity is a key meta-value on which AI policy should be based. Trustworthy artificial intelligence should be the trademark of the EU. A European electronic identification system should be developed to ensure people full control of their digital identity and data online, and to allow safe and easy access to public and private digital services. However, the existing solutions in the field of electronic identification should be taken into account, and their coherence and interoperability should be ensured.
We already know how the situation looks like in Poland and Europe. Time for a representative of the United Nations organization, Mr. Yuang Zhu.
My name is Yuang Zhu. I am a director at the United Nations Secretariat, Department of Economic and Social Affairs, Division for Public Institutions and Digital Government. One of my responsibilities is to work with a team of outstanding professionals at UN offices in Geneva and New York in supporting the United Nations Secretary General's annual Internet Governance Forum, also known as the IGF, where different stakeholders meet on an equal footing to exchange views on critical internet governance issues and explore together solutions. On behalf of the United Nations, I extend a warm welcome to all participants in this game jam, which is helping raising awareness, showcase innovation, and collaboration in support of the objectives of the IGF. Allow me also to take this opportunity to thank the Polish government for organizing this event. Poland has supported the United Nations in organizing this year's IGF, which is taking place virtually this month. And Poland will also be hosting the IGF next year in Katowice. Thank you, Poland. In this challenging period of the COVID-19 pandemic, internet has proven to be vital to us. It connects us online, allowing us to study, to telecommute, to stay in touch with family and friends, and to continue providing essential public services. As pointed out by the United Nations Secretary General, despite facing a growing range of difficulties, the International Committee has stepped up to the challenges, responding to the immediate impact of the COVID-19 pandemic, while also preparing to build a strong recovery based on the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development and the Paris Agreement. In this undertaking, youth will have a big role to play. The dynamics of the internet is very much driven by youth. The young participants at this game jam are smart, innovative, creative, eager to learn, and ready to share. Your knowledge and skills will help propel the internet to evolve and develop in a way that is truly inclusive, a universally accessible, free, secure, and open internet. In this regard, please do keep in mind that there are still more than 3.6 billion people without affordable access to the internet. And among the world's 47 least developed countries, more than 80% of the population is still offline. And the gender gap in online access and connectivity continues to widen. Importantly, this digital divide is accompanied by a growing social divide. The internet is increasingly being used to spread misinformation and disinformation. So how the internet will evolve will be, to a large extent, answered by you. The internet is today very much driven by young people. Young people's spirit, creativity, and innovation often provides the momentum for new ideas and new products online. Young entrepreneurs with vision and drive are often successful leaders of digital firms that create today's platform ecosystem of the internet. And as programmers, youth are very much at the core of the digital transformation we witness today. We see many of them in action during the COVID-19 pandemic, creating contact tracing apps, launching online outreach and education products, fighting misinformation and disinformation. Youth are actually solution-oriented. We have been better able to handle the impact of the pandemic, very much thanks to the creativity of youth. You will help determine the future of the internet, contributing to the responsible and effective governance of the internet and the digital technology. Let us work together to ensure that our world will be truly connected, not only digitally, but also in our shared commitment to the aspiration and values of the United Nations. I wish everyone an exciting, collaborative, and fruitful jam. Thank you.
Could you tell us a little more about the rules and timeline of the GovTech Festival?
From today on, each day will bring you events uniting the world across borders and generations. The whole global community will get involved in 4 weeks of demonstrating how we can use digital technologies to promote the values that can help us get through the pandemic. What values are these? You decide. For the next 4 weeks, each of you will be able to vote for the theme of the game jam. Your vote may inspire hundreds of games and millions of gamers. For those who most actively participate in the discussion on our Facebook event, we prepared some special rewards. In a typical gaming fashion, we will distribute copies of some of awaited games from the country that brought you The Witcher. We can't wait to meet all of you and hear your ideas.
So, in conclusion, we are getting closer to the end, but the organizational details are still worth mentioning. So, registration will be done through the form on the page you can see on the screen right now, where you can choose and vote for the category Game Jam, where you will receive a personal ticket. So, this year's Game Jam categories are as follows. The first category is Connect and Share, the second category is Solidarity, and the third category for which you can vote is No Borders. Thank you very much to all guests of today's material, which is realized thanks to partnership of Industrial Development Agency and GovTech Poland. I once again invite you to vote and register on this page because there are very attractive prizes waiting just for you. The event itself starts on 27th of November 2020, so don't wait, register and collect your name tickets for this year's Game Jam. See you on 27th of November and good luck!